guys back home. And
sorry, my brother. Sorry for the slip of tongue. Today don't make His Excellency retired Brigadier Julius Madabio in 1 year in office. As citizens of this country, me want to take the opportunity for tell them plenty thank you, especially on in flagship program of education, because we need education at this country, and I make so plenty things that go wrong, even in terms of scrutinizing our leaders, in terms of doing checks and balances of people in power. We need education. You'll find out the way at which things we know they go. We not even know how to elect and select members of parliament, people who represent me. But with the help of education, you will see, say, there will be a transformation in terms of, because everybody would like to participate after they have become educated. So I think it's a very good step to the right direction. But I was looking at it this way, that I wish the president could have taken it by phase, like having the primary school on to Beke level, that first phase, and then continue with that. But since it take holistically, we pray as citizens of this country that it achieve in vision and the government become successful, because whosoever become president of this country, is our concern as citizens of this country to make sure that individual succeed in his vision. Because the reason being is, we all say Ilionian, if President Madabio fails, the entire country fails. So we need to make sure, more sure, say we work with the president. Okay, coming back to your question, brother. Just like how they say, His Excellency, you know, one of somebody we come up from a military background, very, very disciplined, and because of that, we look and say, Aluna, look and say, for lead this nation so that we get some transformation and reforms in good governance. Because mind you, democracy is an ongoing process, and as we move on, we should see transformation, we should see reforms, and that makes democracy, that's a tell we say good democracy is growing. Now, in the events in Charlotte, brother, is an unfortunate situation. And this is a test case for His Excellency and his government.
And wait, to Mr. Vakase, that person really don't go off in his train. Yes, look kind of my language.
Okay.
Yes.
Pretoria.
Yes.
So John Akase, MMA brother, this is a test case for His Excellency, the president. Retired Brigadier Julius Madabio is very, very disciplined, and not get any sacred cow in governance, and this make we get confidence in him. The unfortunate incident will happen on the 28th of February. Yes, 28th of February 2019. Yes. It be really, really disheartening, and I'm here to express with dissatisfaction over this particular issue of the Minister of Lands.
Yes,
you know, go waka, brother. When you go waka, listen, my Mr. Moderator, Fritonians or Sierra Leone or Africa, we get with custom and tradition. I can just remember last week I traveled we drive from Freetown to Samu, and I see the extensive land and everything. And when we reach Samo, I see the way how the people welcome we. And these are tradition as Sierra Leonean respect. Amen. We get forget that courtesy, that ethics in meeting where they meet one another. Say, at this time, it's Salon brother, don't come. Look the way he approach me. But you cannot, you know, they go for go meet you, Salon brother. You take four arm vehicle. And I want to make that correction, that man not go for feasibility study. He went for, Dr. Dennis Sandy went for terrify with peaceful coexistence village around the over 300 to 400 years. Take four armed vehicle, we include military personnel, OSD, and police. That is the form of MacPee, as we know. Just imagine the size of Charlotte. Charlotte no one they be known for talking, they not be known for violence.
No, Dennis Vakase.
Yes.
When you say he go with four armed vehicles, what I mean full up.
They full up soldier man. Soldier man, their all armed weapon.
Gone.
They point them people then they enter into the village. If I tell you, as then they enter into the village, just imagine for the first time for Dennis Sadifo enter into Charlotte. For goodness sake, is a community, a well-decent, dignified people them, people that with integrity, people that with credibility, people that are with the law abiding. That man enter forcefully with four vehicle loaded with army personnel, OSDs, police, with guns. The only people that were not gun are the policemen that were been there around them, but the OSDs and the army, we are fully armed.
And what you gonna go do that
in the when we go to the village, everybody be not going to pandemonium. Some people are not going to the bushes them. They run away because you know, I mean, during the interreg norm, now been getting last over 17 years. Mm-hmm. So for let people incident in a dinner, a shock. The school be session be closed down immediately, allow children to go home because then they fear for insecurity. The pregnant woman and below man, the women, they wait for treatment. They go on, they go to their home, they not treat them because they said be the fear. So just see, and as the man enter, he never spoke, he don't talk to anybody. Directly on the mission for start demolition. Just imagine an historical village where you know one day go, you don't know the terrain, you don't understand. And this particular area where this minister go, now the originated area of the inhabitants of our ancestors, the way they mean they. Mind you, in those days, Charlotte formed part of the art of Freetown.
But Dennis Valcarcel,
yes,
the minister, now the custodian of the documents of the land in this country.
Okay,
I get the beliefs the. He know the portion of land we in a state land, and he knows sign of the state land.
Brother, I believe say the Minister of Land then gets the gazette where then get for every state land protected area. And it, I can bet you that the Sandy use this for intimidate, terrify, and a gross abuse of human rights. Like, come to your point.
And before you come to your point,
yes,
I just want the family to say when this issue come at hand. We try all possible means, forget the minister or the public relations officer of the Ministry of Lands. But we make for understand, say, today, now the 1 year of His Excellency, so they all get loaded job, and we call some phones, now they ring. You already ring, then they pick the call. But yet still, we the way to get open hands, we get open doors for anybody from the Ministry of Lands, the minister, and in contingents, therefore come any other time and respond to some of the allegations the way Dennis Valcarcel and Moses Sandy they make concerning the demolition on the 20th February 2019 in Charlotte Village. Go ahead.
But I wish the minister and the deputy, because I don't wrangle with the PRO for quite some time, we are not seeing any tangible reason why they go do this thing. Brother, what I want to say, this is not the tool they talk, a democracy before they see progress and reforms.
Yeah.
We, and a democracy, one of the pillars of democracy, now the rule of law. Without the rule of law, then there is no democracy. Then we're still in the one party system. And what make who voted for this, His Excellency, the new direction, we want some of these old things to go off from us. Look, brother, we have a state institution. When at the judiciary, we have three arms of government, the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary. And they form an institution which has been built. The Ministry of Lands and the Master and Registrar. These are the arms of government that form these two institutions. For goodness sake, how can the minister just lay down, he sleep, he wake one morning, he say, I've forgotten a Charlotte, I've forgotten a battles, I've got demolish houses. But that there are laws. If that minister, like na be state land, he has to go through the law.
So, Dennis Valcarcel, in this case, the minister no inform una before, say, hey, we come na Charlotte Village, oh, we can't do so, we can't do so. You don't know me get any of this kind.
Brother, no. Minister, let me say something. Mm-hmm. I attended the stakeholders meeting for the with the minister. Now we all attend. Me be so much impressed about Dennis Sandy, and I thought that the issue of land grabbing, the issue of all these catchment areas, the issue of deforestation, encroachment will be over. But I want to tell you, no issues has been, no, I'm sorry, none of the issues has not been addressed up till now by this minister. All is about, all what did they say, if they go for recover state land. And I want to say something, my brother. There has been no state land where the Ministry of Lands don't ever take, where they make some reforms. You see them, they plan them, where you go see, say, you go showcase to the nation, say, this is the
now,
land where they recover.
Yes, where this man don't come, it don't end up with soldiers, as you say.
Yes.
OSDs, as you are led, with arms. How come, what did they do exactly? How come they don't enter? What did exactly? How do they explain the pandemic?
Yes. Okay, brother, last is
that will affect
yes, 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 yes. Brother, the minister take this law into, you know, in your hand, you know, for shelve the law as a statement. That man, as soon as he enter, when we go and see the village, it was like a combat zone. On Monday in the rampage everybody of destroying, destabilizing ongoing structures. Like this man even get those ongoing structures. Where don't they come up? Some people in ongoing structures where they're in the roof height. Some people in spam body structures where they not their family live because they're able to afford.
This area, Valcastle, you know, say so you get certain areas where in the green belt, maybe if not the red zone. I believe it's a demarcation they really show us. Maybe when I coach into that zone of green.
Brother, me born a Charlotte. Men a Charlotte. Okay. We took part in the green belt, cutting of the green belt cut across the peninsula.
Yeah.
And when WHH and other organization in the line with the line ministry of the Ministry of Lands, when they don't do this operation done, they gave every villages one map where they show the green belt. This place where this minister would demand as at the heart of Charlotte, Usai, we ancestors.
So that means they will not get them something where they show the
green where belt. They show the green belt.
And no side of the green
and
belt.
What I'll tell you something with the villagers. Mm-hmm. We come on a village. We want with forests, we want with catchment areas to be protected. We want the place to be look greeny so that we get fresh oxygen.
Yeah.
Now waiting they happen now. The city. The city has become so congested that we know they feel good for the now village. So this, now the city, yes. So they try to go back now village.
Okay, there is Valcastle.
Yes.
Now the minister don't go according to you. It demolished.
Yes.
How huge the destruction?
Is what millions of lions. And one of the thing where he say, there's then the PRO and then the minister, the deputy, they will get Guma. We don't get any Guma dam at Charlotte. We not get any national protected part at Charlotte. If you can see this picture, if the cameraman can see us, so people can see him.
Yeah,
you can see. This is not the place where it talks in a protected area connected to Morton.
Mm-hmm.
And Morton, Mogidbash, and Charlotte is an outskirt. I just feel that with the cameraman if you've been there, yeah. For pick them up and do them when they used to say, see them. You know, look at Morton and look at Charlotte.
Like so now, villages.
Yes, no, not to two, it's the same. And that's same a geographical area, different section. Where, like how Regents Day, you get community center, you get Jeremiah Street, you get that just like out in there. So this is the same area, you see. And this village where you look, I mean, all is 100 meter in difference. Now this middle side, this man, they can't talk in a state land. If you see, I look at the structures the way they're not gone. I look at the demolished structures. And I just wait a minute, you see.
So let's look at
you see.
Like how many how I would say almost host them we destroy so. How the worth of the four O's
no.
One flat like that.
It's over 20 structures that have been demolished.
Yeah.
And people they reside now they stop there place that now as they talk they are homeless. The youth say we don't use so they get some job now, they don't get no job. They are vulnerable.
Don't get a meeting with the minister or una the intent for getting a meeting with the minister. But come back to that.
Okay.
Let I just go for a short break. We'll come back
Mr. Sammy.
Moses, you go tell me small about your structure too. We
definitely
tend for big problem inside this particular visit way. The minister will visit Charles Village. Okay, family, we'll go for a short break and we'll come back for telling her more inside Freetown Yagba.
photo for me. Not for me picking them. Not for today. For tomorrow. If not for me, they left so. But not for me picking them. If not for today, I'm not worry. But not for tomorrow. Nothing, no good day for sale. The train from Koldo to Dovecot, I know they see him again. The flagship from Hastings to Gbangbatok, I know they hear him again. The sweet breeze from the Fura Bay, I know they feel him again. The Kotnek, now they've been too many mountains, I know they see him again. If not for me, they left so. But not for me picking them. If not for today, I'm not worried. But not for tomorrow, nothing, no good day for sale. The banana from Banana Island, no rep tear now yet. The pepper from Kabbalah, not a huge Congo market. The traffic light from Kleintown to Congo Cross, the double decker, all don't turn to scrap metals. Oh, now you make the city service bus from Juba Hill to Congo Water not they run again. If not for me, they left so. But not for me picking them. If not for today, I'm not worried. But not for tomorrow, nothing no go there for say. The fish, then I be pond in a Victoria Park. Me man, they know it all. The gold, the diamond, they turn into chain, ring, and bracelet for married with the kingdom. We see Bruno tire. He won't go, they not agree. He run away. Not for me, not for me picking them. Not for today, not for tomorrow. If not for me, they left so. But not for me picking them. But not for tomorrow. Nothing, no good day for say.
Yes, if not for me, lay left so. But not for me, the kingdom, all the fate, all the fate. Now for let the future generation, then get level playing ground in the country. Yes, as we will talk about the land issue in Charlotte Village, family and my own welcome you back to the program Fritton Yagba. Fritton Yagba and the Creole magazine program where they deal with every bit and pieces, things that will happen inside and Mama Sam them together at one table. Then we discuss them. Don't forget, so yourself can be part of the program. Call on the number within your screen right now. Or if you know you don't have your radio set, the number is 079-949494. 079-949494, and you self be part of the program. You can call if you get any issue in your area, you get things where they bug you, the area where you did, you get some deal you want to add to the development of Mama Salon, the line now you get up. You can call on 079-949494. So the floor is open, the phone line now open for let people themselves express their views, concerns, and comments. Now I'll go to you, Moses Sandy. You self now, Charlottonia. Yes, you said, man, Charlotte, today, I've been listening that you don't go for some time. What really happened to you, your site, where really in Charlotte today?
Well, first of all, Mr. Moderator, myself, I actually use this opportunity for congratulate the president, retired.
Pepper Town?
Tengbetown.
Oh, Tengbetown, sorry, yeah, go ahead. Yes. Go ahead. Okay. Thank you very much, my brother, for that humble contribution. The number is 079-949494. People themselves, we get the same problem. So yes,
Say, Mr. Moderator, you understand.
Yeah.
We vote for this government because we want to see some of them change there. But we are very, 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 very disappointed. You understand? Because for the minister for go, he enter our people in place unceremoniously. He starts for destroy. When you ask the man why then they do this kind of act, why then they destroy people and places, they not get one serious thing for tell you. If I for start with, then go start for say because of they want the climate change or whatever, they want protect green belt or green area.
You not ask for
let me say if they want for start okay, with
get documents like that,
you get for if you get issue with me place, challenge me documents, then I go produce me documents.
The line ready for me. Hello, good evening. Your name, where you call from?
Good evening, me Alaji.
Yes, Alaji, you say you call from?
Welcome, ma'am.
Okay, go ahead, Alaji. You're welcome.
Alaji.
Yes, go on, Alaji, go ahead. You give contribution. Thank you very much, my brother. Yes, now thank you. Now you voice, me voice. Now we all voice, they come together as one voice for Bill Mama Saloon. The number we go call and express your views, concern and comment on the program Free Toy Agba. Now 079-949-494. Yes, Sandy.
As I will say, Mr. Or you also of course.
Yeah, go ahead.
Imagine the kind way we Saloon Tanga right now, just like my brother they say.
And first of all, before you left you go. For demolish somebody in place, you get forget a judicial document.
Of course, you get forget.
Judiciary get the bailiff.
Cut over. Yes, well, now what I want to say, I just want maybe you give me some time because Lake Lake land for the callers then.
Yeah.
You understand? For Lake, you don't look me like somebody who is stupid. I go through the due process for get Mendona in a GPS form. When they chat them at the computer, immediately by then the chatting office me the head by one Mr. Idris, you understand? Then you see I'm there and they show you the whole land. If not government land, as soon as then chat them at the system, then you go see the red belt or you go see a pin pan. I'm saying, oh, this now government will patrol the center or this now pond disaster area. The said minister, if you go beyond Guma dam, it was then a prone disaster area just right behind the dam. If you want pull dot, you pull and force by your eye.
You talk about the minister,
of course,
Dr. Dennis.
We are all Sierra Leonean. You can go there tomorrow morning and host there right behind Guma. Usai now the green belt, when they talk about the green belt that they go build in your house, and you they talk about Charlotte Village, where now an historical village, Usai and Walsh come out. You understand? An historical village, Usai. The second church, because the first church of Sierra Leone was found 1808 when I St. John my room. The second church, the second Methodist church, now inside Charlotte Village, one of the oldest churches. You understand? For you want for say we come in there, masters, I'm stupid. Now inside green belts, they go put and the Walsh, you know, a remarkable school right now where don't produce lawyers, doctors, farmers. Imagine.
Now, yes, now look where you go see. Do not get to the documents again.
I have my documents. It is in my car. No, I get my documents. For like my document number signed in the past government by the director. It means now because it don't certify say this now legit business go make it pen down in signature for sign them. These are not stupid people. That is what that make them they pay them for. You understand?
Now, after the money. condition.
I just want to say something before okay, I land. Just like what they say now, free turn yagba.
Yeah.
This land yagba will continue for being yagba if the president not puts foot and do what you would expect no, because we want some reform. How now this minister go come today, he condemn what in a past government don't do, another government come, he condemn who they be victim. Now we the Sierra Leone and them, poor people's them. You understand? If you say you're not a green belt area, what do you get for shorting a green belt? If one begin talk about cutting down of tree, why una they cut down timber, they ship and go now China, what do you benefit from timber cutting? Tell me.
And maybe they realize it.
No, what do you benefit?
Oh, really? That's the simple answer.
You can understand because if we are talking about deforestation, it starts from there.
The authority.
You understand?
Yes.
If you see right now the climate change, you go waka. You go nearly waka naked the way the place hot right now. It starts from there.
But again, on a more serious note, now that shallot area, that Lestapik area, they tell you go to Mount Sugarloaf. Na some like area we na the water catchment where if that water they where we dig the boreholes then where we get drainage the water now from there that mountain and the water they come out. So maybe the minister thought of it say if the water if then go that area there then water business go be a problem and the vegetation go be another problem. I mean, the one is up there. I don't know if they give another explanation. In there.
No, you are getting it all wrong. Charlotte Village, now one village we don't contribute so much on development in Sierra Leone.
Yeah, you understand?
Let me just
learn. Geographical area.
Yeah, let me just learn. If you watch, then people there so sacrifice the waterfall. When I be one sign as Sierra Leone where people and tourists and they come all over for can see then turn them into a mini hydro. Like you understand?
Hold on, I think I lost this person. Call on the number 0799494494. His voice is very important to me. We wait for the call.
I think we can address.
I want to let Dennis land.
I think we can address that issue there because as a born of Charlotte, at least I know much better about the village. Okay. One of the things we can tell you that the mountain district, ask any indigenous cut across from Gloucester to Charlotte, none indigenous of that particular village will like to deforest their mountains. Even the catchment area we find stream when they swim. If I tell you the Ministry of Lands, they don't sign document for all the area then they take a conducted tour from Regent to Jui. All that we find stream then the only side where we find out say we stream they not touch Naina Charlotte. You go to Regent, go to Bathurst, go down Mote Mogegba. In fact, one of the saddest things this minister did, when we've been there, the previous government been there, for goodness sake, make we the update and applaud people and for good things. Not that everything where the former the government do be wrong. We know say the there are weaknesses.
Big brother. Hello, welcome to the program. Hello. Hello. Okay, I think
we know say there are weaknesses and errors for any government. And why they put a monitorium there from Regent to Jue until the former president of diet in people and they say they want a standard building structures where they will bring come up so they cut across and see say we get some side where we'll showcase say this place you get a very fine village scenery and a drive and then on the right hand side part of them will get catchment area we're prone to disaster. There was a structure
where they come from Regent, they come now.
On the left hand side, on the right hand side, we have this monitoring way. Then we want to make a very good structure for cut across. But check out now, the only side we go see, say, they not do no buildings, the Bathurst and the rest of Charlotte area. Now, on the left hand side, we get prone area where we, the indigenous, they not go left for left, they may host day because of that waterway, the stream, very nice stream.
Okay, I think we're going to contribute to the program tonight. Yes, sir, good evening, yes, ma'am. Welcome to the program, Future Agba. Yes, now your name now, where they call from? Yeah, you're welcome. What is your contribution? Okay. Okay.
exactly.
Thank you very much, my dear brother. You voice me.